I'm going to tell this story in reverse order, just to be fancy. In 2011, Nicolas, Wendy, and Refn premiered Drive at the Cannes Film Festival. You may have heard of it. It was one of the great sensations of that year, and this image quickly became an icon. Gosling built a hieratic character, sparing with his words and never defined by the gestures or his dialogue. But what he does on screen. This kind of existential hero has much in common with another famous character of the big screen. In 1978, Walter Hill directed The Driver. Here, the leading character is a driver played by another Ryan, Ryan O'Neill. This driver is also in trouble because of his association with various criminals. But there are more commonalities between Drive and the driver than just that. The anti-hero played by Ryan O'Neill is also cold-blooded, sparing with words, and usually expressionless. Even both of them are blonde. We could say that both films have the same leading character. Now let's jump back further another decade. In 1967, the legendary French filmmaker Jean-Pierre Melville created together with Alain Delon the epitome of his existential anti-hero, a figure that he would revisit later in his filmography. He's an assassin who barely speaks, an executor, a serious man who never smiles, who never expresses his feelings. And again, a protagonist who is never defined by his emotions or by what he says, but only by what he does. Between Les Samouraï and The Driver, there are many plot similarities. We could almost say that both films are the same film, and that for half a century, the same character has come to star in three films by three different filmmakers. But there is one big difference. Love. The character of Ryan Gosling in Drive is in love, and this is what marks his decisions. So, if Drive and The Driver share so many elements, and if The Driver and Les Samouraï are almost the same film, well, is Drive then the romantic version of Les Samouraï? What do you think?